Hi, everybody. Bob Clark from The Morning Show, Pat Frisch Middays, and our buddy T.J. Trout from The Afternoons. And guys, huge political news earlier this week when Tom Udall announced he's not running for re-election in 2020. His seat's not even cold yet, and people are lining up to take it over.
Susana Martinez is the only Republican I can think, but will she actually get into the race? Democrats have a huge field to pick from.
Oh, absolutely. But, I mean, I'm sure the governor's thinking about it, the lieutenant governor under her term, John Sanchez. I think there's a couple of Republican state representatives who might jump in, people who have a lesser name statewide but are fresh faces.
Barnes.
Sarah Maestas Barnes. Now, and also Kelly Fajardo.
Well, you know what else's name was brought up yesterday when I was talking about it on the air was RJ.
I don't think that's going to happen.
Yeah, he's going to make his announcement. He's going to drive in on an art bus.
Yeah.
Go,
yeah,
on, everybody, I'm here.
Yeah. I think there was a time a few years ago where he might have considered it, but not now.
Well,
on the Democratic side.
Oh, God.
Oh, my goodness. You've got
50 people.
Yeah. But the two names at the top of the list, Ben Ray Lujan and then Attorney General Hector Balderas.
Would Lujan want to leave the chance of becoming the first majority Hispanic in the House?
Well,
majority leader.
That's a calculation that he's going to have to make because the Democrats do have the majority in the House.
Right.
He is a part of, he's an ascending member of their leadership team on that side.
Right?
Yeah.
I'd go for it. I'd run for Senate.
Yeah.
Because you don't know what Pelosi's going to do.
Yeah.
You
know? I know. And some people have mentioned Maggie Toulouse-Oliver on the Democratic side, but I just don't know if she has the political gravitas yet to take on someone like Hector Balderas or Ben Ray.
Yeah, speaking of mayors, I mean, they even brought up Keller. Keller's like,
he came out almost immediately and said, you know what, I'm committed to being mayor of Albuquerque.
You need some equity first.
Absolutely.
Right. This may have lost some flair because you said it earlier.
Yeah.
Pelosi doesn't know what she's going to do next. She has no clue.
You should
know that.
If the Dems stay in power, I predict she will stay in power.
Look, we already knew 2020 was going to be a really fun election year nationally, but now in New Mexico, it's gotten even more fun.
Yeah. I'm excited.
Absolutely.
That's a multi-million dollar race right there. And think about the Udall family. Mo Udall was minority leader, I think, in the House. He was from Arizona. He was an uncle, I believe, right?
Yep.
And then there was
There's a Udall up in Colorado.
Right,
yep.
Well, what a shocker. You know, I guarantee you he's got something he's going to step right into.
Well, he thinks he's going to be attorney general. Because Trump's going to lose in the next election. And that ain't happening. Back to you, Bob.
Absolutely. Speaking of fun, I had fun earlier this week while YouTube bozos were still at work. I went to the Isotopes game on Monday afternoon against the Rockies. And unbelievable, perfect weather, 12,222 people on a Monday afternoon.
Love that concept.
Absolutely.
Just the major league, minor league.
The Isotopes won.
Yeah, we're going to have them on today on my show. We're going to talk to the Isotopes.
Who, the Rockies?
No, the Isotopes.
Who from the Topes?
GM. Mr. Traub.
Oh, Traub.
Yeah, he's going
to
come in.
I heard they signed a tentative extension to
through
2022.
Yeah, no, they're all set.
Nice.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
and not only did the Isotopes win the game, but our mascot, Orbit, they brought Dinger from Colorado down. He sucks. I mean, Orbit just kicked his ass.
Good. They're going to call him up, I heard.
Well, they should have done an MMA thing between the two of them. On the pitcher's mound.
Absolutely. Yeah. Hey, your weekly premium insider's code word is spring.
Text
Isotopes to 62582 for your chance to win four tickets to the April 19th Topes game, a family Friday night game. Good luck, everybody. Enjoy the NCAA tournament this weekend, too.